when you enter a sale in, there are a number of things you can do. For instance, if I didn't want to enter an invoice, I could certainly enter a quote or an order or an invoice in any of those forms. If I enter a quote first, it turns into either an order or an invoice. If I enter a quote, I can turn that directly into an invoice. You don't have to go through the order if I don't want to. Now, if I put an order in, the difference between an order and a quote is the order will affect your inventory. So if I put an order in for a particular inventory item to be sold, it will effectively say that that inventory item is on a sales order, and it would reduce my inventory by the amount of that inventory being sold. That's an important distinction between a quote and an order. A quote does not affect your inventory numbers, and an order does. Now, the only thing that's going to affect your general ledger in this case is an invoice. So a quote or an order will not affect your general ledger invoice. It will not increase revenue at all. Once I have a transaction in the system, then I can look up in the transaction journal just as I could in the banking section. And from here, I could select by a date range or an ID number, in this case, 356. Or I can drill down using the arrow to a particular transaction. In this case, I know it's an invoice. And I know that I can, from here, if I needed to, I could theoretically modify an invoice if I had the rights to do that. I could modify the account number. I could modify the amount, and I would resave it. So if a person has rights to do that, they could certainly do that. And that just about sums up the sales section of our command center in MYOB Premier Accounting for Windows. Thank you and have a great day.